Today's service is very close in emphasis and theme to that of Pentecost 7. The main difference lies in the strong focus of today's worship on God's activity through His Word. Pentecost 7 taught us that God expects His children to show their faith in renewed living, while today's service teaches that the Word as a means of grace actually works in us to give new life. In the Old Testament lesson this morning, God proclaims His uniqueness. There is no other God. He has proven His glory by His prophecies, and we can trust Him. The Old Testament lesson this morning is written in the 44th chapter of Isaiah, beginning at the 6th verse. This is what the Lord says, "Israel's King and Redeemer, the Lord Almighty, I am the first and I am the last. Apart from me, there is no God. Who then is like me? Let him proclaim it. Let him declare and lay out before me what has happened since I established my ancient people and what is yet to come. Yes, let him foretell what will come. Do not tremble. Do not be afraid. Did I not proclaim this and foretell it long ago? You are my witnesses. Is there any God besides me? No. There is no other rock. I know not one." Here endeth the Old Testament reading. We are taught in the epistle lesson this morning that the Spirit, knowing our human weakness, prays on our behalf. And the epistle lesson will be read just before the sermon. The Holy Gospel is the parable of the weeds in the field. In it, Jesus teaches that Satan has done his dirty work also in the church, and as a result, the church is also rendered impure in this world. Yet God knows those who are His, and will at the final harvest separate the good from the bad. Please rise as we, out of respect for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel is written in the 13th chapter of St. Matthew, beginning at the 24th verse. Jesus told them another parable. "The kingdom of heaven is like a man who sowed good seed in his field, but while everyone was sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. When the wheat sprouted and formed heads, then the weeds also appeared. The owner's servants came to him and said, 'Sir, didn't you sow good seed in your field? Where then did the weeds come from?' 'An enemy did this,' he replied. The servants asked him, 'Did you want us to go and pull them up?' No, he answered, 'because while you are pulling the weeds, you may root up the wheat with them. Let them both grow together until the harvest. At that time, I will tell the harvesters, first collect the weeds and tie them in bundles to be burned. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn.' Then he left the crowd and went into the house. His disciples came to him and said, 'Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field.' He answered, 'The one who sowed the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world, and the good seed stands for the sons of the kingdom. The weeds are the sons of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. As the weeds are pulled up and burned in the fire, so it will be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send out His angels, and they will weed out His kingdom, everything that causes sin and all who do evil. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. He who has ears, let him hear." Here endeth the Gospel.